they are ministers to distribute Holy Communion. A special reason. They are called extraordinary. In the church language, extraordinary is less than ordinary. That is church language, canonical language. So they are extraordinary. Why? In the ordinary situation, it is the bishop, priests and deacons who distribute the Holy Communion. Ordinary situation. Therefore, they are the ordinary ministers. There can be extraordinary situations, like what we have here, a huge number of people receiving the Holy Communion. Therefore, priests alone cannot manage this huge number. They call hours together to finish the Holy Mass. Therefore, the Church has provided, or started with Pope Paul VI, giving this special privilege to specially deputed people from the laity to come forward to distribute the Holy Communion to the people. And therefore, they are specially deputed. We should all know that, specially deputed. They have been trained, they have been formed and instructed well so that they distribute the Holy Communion in a worthy manner, as much as possible. Who is worthy to distribute the Holy Communion? No one. Even I am not worthy. These hands are most unworthy to take the body of Jesus and distribute. So never think of the human presence in the extraordinary ministers. They are unworthy. I am unworthy. All the priests, all the bishops, even the Holy Father is unworthy to touch the body of Jesus Christ. But Jesus Christ wants us to do that. In spite of our sinfulness, as I said in the beginning, Jesus honors us. This is the honor that Jesus gives us in spite of our unworthiness, our sinfulness. Therefore, no one should feel bad to receive the Holy Communion from the extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion. Because the bread is consecrated at the time of consecration, and it has become the body and blood of Jesus Christ, not while distributing the Holy Communion. It's already the body of Christ. Whoever gives it, it's the body of Christ. There is nothing special about when bishop gives, it's a better body. When priest gives, it's slightly lesser. And extraordinary minister gives tolerable. We shouldn't go with such attitude. And instead, it has become the body of Christ when the priest says, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body. It has become. No one can change it after that. No change takes place. It's the same body of Jesus Christ that gives. So, in our extraordinary situation of huge number of people receiving the Holy Communion, we need that. And for that, these people are specially deputed. Let us therefore accept them wholeheartedly as people selected to distribute the body of Jesus Christ to the faithful, and the new members come in. Some of the old ones will step out, and it will go on in cycles. After a few years, these will step down, and new members will come down. So as long as they are in the ministry that is receiving the body of Jesus, we may have personal differences with the rest of outside the church. When you count inside the church, they're all ministers of the Holy Communion, and therefore receive as if they receive from the bishop or from the priest. And it is, you are not honoring them, you are honoring Jesus Christ, who has willed to be your food questions, 7 minutes now.
There is this banner carrying an Bernard Schaeffer and Jody Barbota. Bella Toscano, Doreen J. Correa. Baby Abraham and Ricardo Velasco. Arul Joseph and Edward Garcia. Arukraj Arukim, Edwin Alexander. Alice Catherine, Fernando Joseph. Teresita Dalmostein and Fitzroy Fernando. Vicky Burgess and Grace K. Victor. Joseph Stephen and Salom Pereira. Joseph Anthony Matthew Dalio. Joseph Silva Nivemen Hotensi. Jordi Thomas, Maria Gomez. Jordi Joseph, Molly Andrews. Jacinte Ozurwa, Nascimento Corsica. Filomena de Souza, Natalie Fernandez. James Agustin, Pablo Bartley. Sebastian Lobo, Sharmila James. Sebastian Stanley Rivera. Saras Paribaran Sunita Sikira. Renato Amelo Suresh Jason.
So we congratulate all the newly inducted happy welcome to this extraordinary ministry, and you know what you are about. Do it with all the seriousness that it deserves to be committed, to be punctual, and be at the service of the people you promised to serve. It's the service, it's never an honor, but the service to the community of St. Mary's. I wish to thank also the Assembly ministers who are sitting down. Thank you very much for the services that you did for a few years. And may God bless you for all the sacrifices you made. This ministry requires a lot of sacrifice. It's spent a lot of time. Not enough to see to come for one mass a week and go home. They have to be there for several masses, especially on important days. Easter Day, Morning Thursday, you will see they have to be there. And they have promised to do that. So it's not easy for all these sacrifices to step down ministry. Thank you all very much. In a very special way, I would like to thank Praveen, who will be stepping down. The one who was reading out the names. He is the leader of the Estaban ministers. He has also finished his term. He did his job wonderfully well. Very meticulously planning everything regarding the ministry. They are not just coming and distributing Holy Communion. There's a big planning where they should go, which spot they should be, and when they should come to the church and all these things with the charge here. The leader plans everything, especially on big days. And Mr. Praveen has been doing it so wonderfully well. Praveen, we appreciate you. We thank you.